What is up, everybody? It is the very first booking show of TEW with Jim Foster. Vtech is with me, and yes, we are talking after our blow up. So select.
What blow up?
You have not spent any of the available talent points in your team. So Vtech is actually going to walk me through this. Mm-hmm. The first time, so if you see the cursor moving, you'll see it's either me or Vtech, so...
Go to user talents, unless you want me to do it.
Right here?
Yeah, remember what you did for, like, the test run?
Yes.
What did we go with, Chaotic Genius, or...
We went with... We went with Creative Leader.
Yeah, you just hit apply and save. And then, was there any certain preferences you wanted to turn on or off?
Oh, I did all this.
Okay, so that's good. Select. And do you want to have, like, Dave Meltzer and Bill Apter and all them show up or not?
No, I want to do this on my own. Because I'm a greedy bastard.
Okay.
No, I don't.
What is that?
Do you want to? Change what? Color?
That's your thing.
Alright.
So you have a ton of choices to go with, or you could go with none and you could build your own company.
I would like to get your opinion on, being as this is the first episode, I'd like to see what you would like to see me book.
It's very interesting because each company is a little different. Like, some are wrestling based, like strictly wrestling. Some of them are more Attitude Era, you know, style, where you can do risky angles. Some of them are completely hardcore. Others are all about sports entertainment. Like, take for example Smoky Mountain Wrestling. That would be, you know, all about wrestling. It's not. As, like, WWE PG, they're trying to do the whole sports entertainment route where they'll make a lot of money, but they won't get a lot of respect, but the wrestlers will be more popular than others, but they're, like, they won't be as skilled. It's kind of like what you just want to take in as your pride and joy. Or you could, you know, run your own company and find people who are out there and hire them.
You know what? Let's go ahead and... What do you think? Should I book Ohio Valley Wrestling or Mid-South? Is Mid-South in here? Yes, it is. Ohio Valley or Mid-South? Or Jim Crockett?
With your luck with all those, because I think they're all small, you might as well just make your own company. Where's Jim Crockett at? Jim Crockett, I think, is a little bit bigger, yeah.
Yes.
But
should I go ahead and book that?
You could get some good people. It's all about wrestling, by the way. So, like, storylines won't necessarily mean,
maybe,
like, you have to follow strict rules.
Maybe World Championship Wrestling?
Which WCW is this, though?
This is right around the time Eric Bischoff came in.
Says Ted Turner and Jim Herd.
This is when Eric Bischoff was an announcer.
So is this like, you know, when it was Ric Flair and Sting at, you know,
yes,
at the mall and all,
yes,
that, like, very early? Yeah, I can see that being good.
Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and do this.
Yeah, it looks good.
Select owner.
So with owner you have full power, whereas booker you would have to follow Ted Turner's rules.
All right.
So, what you want to do here first? Let's do some background and stuff for the game. Anything you want to change at all? It's full power to you. Whether you want to have auto save on, you want to be able to skip more than one day. If you want to have you actually can't do new worker frequency because it's turned off in this mod pack. You can do relationship frequency and all the way down under. system.
It's a very interesting thing. I think I'll keep it Kenny deaths.
Yeah, it's like, for instance, like, Hulk Hogan was walking down the street and a steamroller hit him. It's not just like, oh, he had a heart attack. Like, heart attack is a natural death, but, like, a steamroller, that's a Kenny death, because no. It's comical.
Regeneration would be them coming back from the dead?
Kinda not. It's like their child would basically be a replica of them.
Okay.
So it'd be like Hulk Hogan Jr.
Right. Yeah. Alright. So we go back.
Go to the cell phone icon. Well, actually, you probably want to check out like what's going on in wrestling, so you can read all this. WCW has fallen to Jim Foster.
Financialized from Hulk Hogan.
Yeah. Whoever makes the most money in the game, he'll, yeah. Hulk Hogan, $76,000 a month. I'm surprised. Like, if WWF Classic doesn't go bankrupt, I'll be surprised.
Alright. So.
So right now, you can also check out the, you know, the greatest 500 wrestlers moment and some other stuff, where you can just jump in here and look at your roster and all that.
And where would my roster be?
It's the creative suite down here. There.
Right there?
Yeah. No, that was,
go ahead, click away.
That was your creative meeting.
Right.
Roster. There we go.
Wow, what a roster. Big Van Vader, Brad Armstrong, Lord Steven Regal.
Brian Pillman.
Yeah, this is really good.
Jesse Ventura.
My question is that can I try to make deals with some people that aren't working for World Championship Wrestling?
Here's the fun part. With being the mod that it is, some people will be... Like, I can already guess. I'm already going to take a guess. Like, Hulk Hogan and John Cena, they're going to be written. So that means you have to wait until someone ticks him off, or he just doesn't want to re-sign.
Right.
Whereas someone like JBL, yeah, you could go and get him, because he's pay-per-appearance.
Right.
And someone will try to, like, bid and get him. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to hire, so only people you hire will be able to show up. And if you want to change this to wrestlers or whoever you want to hire.
A wrestler. Right now is a wrestler.
What are you looking for in terms of gender, male, female, both?
I'm looking for both.
Okay. Actually, are you doing the females?
I'm going to build the company and then bring the women in.
Okay. Do you want to just show everyone, or you want to start from like the very popular people and work your way down?
Very popular people, and let's start with the males only.
Okay. So let's start with, I'm going to do people who are at least a draw.
Least a draw.
Okay. So yeah, it's not that many.
I'll definitely take Chris Benoit. Let's see what he wants.
Okay.
Now, do I ask him if he wants... How do I go about doing...
You would get go to negotiate. So the very good thing about this is he's only... your company is too small for him.
Okay.
So the thing is, he's touring with New Japan. So that means that no one has him, not even New Japan. Because he's only doing it like a touring season. And then he's like going to be a freelancer.
Wow, everybody's turning me down.
The weird thing is your company's number 6 in the world.
Ooh.
Sid Vicious.
Willing to listen to offers, so now yeah. What?
I hit close, and then it'll open up a negotiation screen. And it will tell people who want to hire him and who likes him and who doesn't like him.
Let's see. He would be... Written? Contract would be your role on the roster would be
if you need help with like explaining any of those, I got you. Oh, my chair. That's my back.
You expect a bonus of 20. I don't want to play with tethers. Not too much. Sweet deal, I'm offering you. Wage creative control. Nah. Nothing extra. A non-complete clause is included. Signing it.
So that means that if he gets angry, he's not allowed to compete for like so many months.
Alright, so Paul White, Gorgeous George, let's see how Booker T feels about his old home. No, I didn't think so.
Because of the NWO WCW version.
RVD?
You might be able to get him. Funny thing is, he's with ECW at the moment. Terry Funk.
That means hiring Vito means that he can help give me, like, I can say, hey, I want to hire this guy, and he goes, nah, I don't know about that.
Yeah, he can completely deny it.
Okay. And
so I would look at his relationships.
Okay. Would that make me go out of this? Yes, I know we're recording, but I don't care.
It will make you go out of, this little window. Not the recording, but
relationships. Chemistry?
No, it's right here. Relationships.
Oh.
There you go. There's everything you ever need to know about his entire
okay.
You know, people he likes. So like, he has a strong dislike of Hulk Hogan and Shane Douglas, which might get in the way of hiring either one of them later on. That's pretty much it, I see. I don't see anyone else he dislikes.
I think that's fine. So, and Yokozuna, probably gonna say no. Oh!
I said, yeah.
Wow! Exclusive. Devil's Mark offer. Contract would be.
Get some real quick. But after you get him, go to filter and then go to the setting right under it and change to exactly.
And again, we're here doing our first TEW. And filter. I have no idea what I'm doing. Unemployed. Let's look at our unemployed people. Al Snow is unemployed.
Okay, so how did it go with changing to the one below?
I did not know what you meant, so I just told that offers you to expect more money around 60 or at least some other perks, so let's bring Al Snow's up just a little bit.
Make him more he only wanted 6,010, by the way.
Yeah, well, I just want to sweeten the pot. So, again, you said to go to filter?
Filter.
And
wrestler hire male. And they are exactly a recognizable wrestler. So there's gonna be a lot more now.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gain one kill. I was on the unemployed list right then.
This has people that are also employed with places, but so it will kind of be like a war to see who you can get. Not to mention people in your roster aren't really, like, I don't know if they're guaranteed, because some people could try to snatch them up also, being how there's a lot of companies and a lot of just a lot of people have money in general in this game.
Bubba Ray and Devon are both available. I'm going to get myself a tag team. Is there a salary cap on here?
What do you mean?
Well, when you play like when you play football or GM on a hockey game, you normally have a salary cap. Or is this you're playing with Ted Turner's money?
You could use as much money as you want and spend as much money as you want, but it's like at the end of the month it will tell you how much money you've earned, how much money you've lost, and you'll just have to like go from there of like who you'll release and stuff. And a dangerous thing that you're doing is you're doing written for a lot of people, and you actually have to buy out their contract if you want to get rid of them. But if they get injured, they'll also stay. So if like Devon Dudley got, you know, if he got injured and it was like a retirement thing, and he is the worst person on the microphone to have, he's basically useless, and you'd have to buy out his contract to get rid of him. Because there would be no use for him ever again, since he'd be out of wrestling. Whereas if he was pay per appearance, you could send him back right there. Even as mean as that sounds, but it just depends how prone they are to getting injured and what, like, how useful they are after, you know, injury.
Road Dog Jesse James. Christian Cage. Dean Malenko. Dick Murdoch. Gonna go ahead and go back to the filter and look for the unemployed again. Where are the unemployed? Ah, there they are. Ah. Alright, so being as VTech's not here anymore, I'm going to go ahead and try to figure this thing out all by myself. So I'm going to see if I can get some more people on my roster. And not really sure what's going on. I mean, like, this is my first time doing the game, so. And I want to hire some people who would make it a really big impact on what I'm trying to do booking-wise. And, I want them to be, and my dogs are barking, and they probably want to go outside, see if the barbarian's on her. They let him outside! WCW's too small for him. Bob Holly. Awesome. $1,750 is what Bob wants. We'll give him $1,750. Let's see here. So we're going to keep looking. Bob Sweet Tan would be a great person to have on because of what I'm looking for. So I'm gonna up Bob and exclusive, and as one of our icons, push would be normal, he'd be available for all shows. You expect a bonus of 20%. And then make the new offer, and hopefully we'll have Bob Sweet Tan on our roster. Bobo Brazil, oof. Brad Armstrong, oh gosh. I'm telling you what, I'm really happy with all this. Bret Hart, let's see if Bret will come work for us. Ah, WCW is too small. Brian Kendrick. Brian Lee.
The other Undertaker.
Hey, we know that Brock Lesnar's not going to come work for us. $1,400 will we give for $350. He's hired by WWE PG, Buddy Roberts, and Rogers. Oh wow. Bobby Cannon. And I have no Vtech to bounce off of. So I'm here all alone booking the show. Chavo Guerrero Jr. Let's see if Chavo will come back. He's willing to listen to offers. Let's see what Chavo wants. And let's keep Chavo on for a year. So, let's see here. Chris Cuby. Chris Candido, keep him on for 2 years, exclusively in ring. Make him an offer, see what he wants, $1,310. They always want more money. There you go, Chris Candido will be hearing back from him, hopefully. Let's take another shot. Chris Candido, Chris Champion, Chris Hamrick, Chris Jericho. Let's see. Chris Masters. Christian York. I'm sure Daniels. Let's see how he feels about it. As a signing bonus, I'm willing to offer you $1,000. Let's see how he likes that. Let's see if he likes $1,000. Sweet deal. Creator control. Let's see how he likes it. Yes. Alright. So, let's go ahead and see if which CM Punk are we dealing with. Cole Cabana. CW Anderson. Let's get CW on. CW. 3 years. Written. Unlimited appearance. Unlimited appearances. Exclusive in ring. Attention is usually useful. You'd be available for all nights. Expect 30% bonus because you're a friend of mine. Pay per view and TV. And make new offer. Yes. Let's hope we hear back from C. W. Anderson. Davey Boy Smith of the meet. David Crockett. David Von Erich. Don Marie. Dean Malenko. Dixie Carter. I wouldn't hire Dixie Carter even if I had the money. Let's see. Should we see about D'Lo Brown? D'Lo. Let's see what D'Lo wants. Let's keep D'Lo on for 2 years. Then let's go ahead and end our Skype call with, he will call us back, I'm sure. And we'll go back to the game. So we'll have him in ring. And we'll use use him as one of our icons. And we'll see, how does he feel about it? He's good to go, and we're going to hopefully hear back from him. Don Harris. Gotta find his brother. Ron and Don. Doug Basham. Alright. So, let's keep moving along here and see. Gilbert. Let's see here. Earl Hebner. Definitely need a. We are going to use him as. Exclusively as a referee. And. Yep. Earl Hebner. Hopefully he's coming along. Let's see if we get Eddie on as an authority figure to help build our company. Well, don't worry about it, Eddie. We'll just move on. Okay, not a problem. What Eddie Guerrero are we dealing with? Let's see. He feels WCW are too small for him. That's okay. Edges. Not a problem. We understand. No hurt feeling. El Tejano. Elijah Burke. Right here in Jacksonville. Let's see if he comes to work for. Let's see here. Wrestler. Let's put Elijah in here for a year. And let's see what Elijah wants. Filter it because scouting for a broadcaster. Let's see here. Who do we want to get? David Crockett, Dutch Mantel, Gorilla Monsoon, Gordon Sully. Let's see if Gordon Sully will come work for us. Yes. Awesome. Let's see what Gordon wants. Oh. Nope. Let's. As an announcer. Yes. Alright. Alright. Gordon Sully. And who are we going to put him on? Are we going to put him with Jim Foster? Yeah, you cannot start negotiations with yourself. Jim Ross, Joey Styles, and Gordon Sully. Let's see if my buddy Byron is here. Yes, he is. I'm gonna put Byron. I hope you're watching this. I am putting you with Gordon Sully. No, I do not want to put him in my short list. Byron's working for NXT. It's alright, Byron. I love you, buddy. I'm so proud of you. Kevin Kelly. Let's see if he'll come work for us. Aha! Alright, let's go back to the filter. And let's find the color commentator. Mark Madden. Jonathan Cage. Lord Alfred Hayes. Matt Stryker. All right, let's get some referees here, because we've only got Earl Hebner. Let's get a referee here. All right, so we got Charles Robinson. Let's get some, let's see what Charles wants. Only as a referee. Baby Hebner, as he's called on the Twitter. He's a referee. Yes, we're gonna make that official. And let's see, let's get a couple more. Jim Corderas. And let's see here, as a referee. Mickey J. Absolutely. Oh, Nick Patrick. Love you, Mickey, but Nick Patrick. Filter, we get ourselves a couple of road agents, and then we'll go back and see. Angel Apofo, Bill Watts. Let's see if Bill Watts will come work for us. Nope, Mid-South Wrestling. Tyler Herrera Sr. Let's see. Negotiate? Yes. As a road agent. Court power, absolutely. So let's see if Vtech wants to get back on the call. I'm going to probably pause here. So we're back, and we're gonna see if we can get a couple more road agents. See if Dutch Mantel will come as a road agent, and let's bring him on for a year. I think I have everything in place, but again, VTech's not here, so I'm going to go ahead and schedule. I really don't know what I'm doing. to go ahead and close this out. And I think Vtech told me how to do this, but I don't remember. So, let's see what we can do here. Dojos, workers, companies. Media, game world. New, nothing to report. So, I have no help from Vtech, so I'm kind of on my own here. Awesome. Very cool. So, where are we? Where is WCW in all this? Where's my version? Looks like we're way back in the back. Yeah, we're gonna have to build, or we're not even on the list. Are we on the list? Did I miss us? Looks like I missed us, or we're not even on the list. Are we on the list at all? I don't see us on the list at all. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and haul the mortals. Ah, nice. So let's go ahead and back. No. No, I do not wish to. Let's see here. Oh, Vtech, where are you? This is probably very boring to anybody that's watching it, so I'm just going to go ahead and pause it until I start booking. So, Vtech is back. And, again, like I said, I really don't know what I'm doing here. So, basically, Vtech is going to be helping me through my first booking on my own so that I can learn how to do TEW. Now, TEW, we're working on Monday, week one, January 2013. And as I said before, Vtech knows this very well, and he's been doing this for a very long time. I used to go on TeamViewer on his computer and book on his computer. So he's here to help me through my first show to where I can learn to book on my own.
Hey there.
Isn't that right, Vtech?
Yep.
So, just to run you through everything, I don't know if this got recorded or not, and I know it didn't, so I did a pre-booking.
Mm-hmm.
And so I booked a tag team match, a 10-minute match, 15-minute match, 30-minute match, and the backstage attack, and then I closed it out, and now is where I need you to walk me through. How do I go ahead and start my first? It says Jim Foster needs to be assigned a position on the roster.
So just double click that.
Okay.
And then whatever you want him to be, because what the game wants him to be is might be different. It's like right now they want him to be.
Okay, like so it's, we can do color commentator. Color commentator. And
save.
And save.
Right. And then what you want to do for this is announcers, and then you want to add him to this.
Okay. Let me go ahead and... Alright, cool. That is not who I picked.
Mm-hmm.
I picked Gordon Sully and someone else. So.
For announcers?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? I'm negotiating to have them come on.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you have to wait a couple days, and then if you hire someone they don't like, it even takes longer. So.
All right, so let's go ahead, and once you're done with that, Vtech, of course, is doing all this fast stuff because he's a young guy and knows. So, Vtech, walk us through how we would go ahead and start our first show.
Well, first you need to simulate by 5 days. Let's do this real quick. You turned multi-advance off. Let's do partial. And with partial, it will stop the game if, for instance, one of the people you signed, they accept the negotiations and they become part of your roster. That's the only way the game will actually stop. Otherwise, it will just go up to the day of the show, and then it will make sure that you confirm that you want to go into the booking of the show instead of the, you know, like, backstage stuff. So.
So, good thing I'll be able to go back and listen to this and watch how you did that again.
Yeah, well, there's also all my tutorials that I've done with, I think I did them with Cole and maybe Faber, I think. No, Brian.
Speaking of Faber, he announced his retirement yet again.
Oh, he's retired again or not retired?
He said after 7 or 8 years, gonna go ahead and, you know, retire again.
Okay.
And it's sad because when he's on, he's on.
Well, I'll see him back in 3 months, maybe. Who knows? Just depends on how the timing is.
You're lagging really bad.
So are you.
We're lagging together.
It's a team effort. Well, it is simulating the game, and there's over a couple thousand people. Seeing how this spans from you know, the 50s all the way up to 2015, so, you know.
So
something happened in the game, so you can check any of this if you want to, or you can go check your cell phone.
I'll go check my cell phone. Let me go ahead and do that.
Yeah. Mail. Okay, so emails. Steven Regal has signed with SMW, Teddy Long, SMW, Elijah Burke, SMW, Jim Corderis, Maple Leaf is trying to steal him, and Matt Stryker, WXW, is trying to steal him.
So, how would I go ahead and take care of Jimmy Corderis?
So, anyone that they're trying to steal, you want to click on their name, and then go to negotiate. And you'll be able to check what they're giving you, and it'll also say if it's being taken seriously or not.
Oh, it's not, then I'm not worried about it.
Okay. Matt Stryker, his was another, okay, not being taken seriously. WXW, I'm trying to think of what that was. That was on MTV, right?
I believe so.
Wrestling Society X, maybe, right?
Yes.
Bishop Burke. Not take it seriously. So you have nothing really to worry about with them trying to steal these people. Just as long as, like, here it still has all of these people listed, then you're good. I like how you got Dutch Mantel. He's one of my favorites. Dirty Dutch. So you can simulate the 4 days, but at this rate, it looks like it's just going to stop every day and inform you of something happening.
So when do we get to our first?
It's supposed to be in 4 days. So, 4 days could be like 4 minutes, 5 minutes. 4 days could be like 15 minutes, depending on, like, if someone wants to steal your talents. Because not everyone in your roster, like, for instance, Vader, I don't think he is written contract. We have to check.
So, yes. Frontier Martial Arts Wrestling, I'm trying so hard not to just go all over and just look at every single roster.
I mean, you could do that, you know, off screen.
I'm basically looking at the unemployed list and people that I really, really like. Vtech, are you still there?
Yes.
Alright. So we were doing really good when this stopped, and now that it's loading, and now it's lagging really bad. But hey, we're both lagging, so it's a team effort.
It is a team effort. Just you, me, and Kid Fight.
Yeah, you, me, and Kid Fight.
Okay, so if you just saw what happened on the screen, looks like someone trying to get Sid Vicious. Might be you, might be someone else.
Yeah, so the pre-booking, is that going to be, is that going to be our first show?
You can drag and drop it into your show, and you'll just have to see like how much time it consumes.
For hire. Wow.
They might, you know, if he's.
And we've lost VTech again.
Sorry, Cole was messaging me. It was like, hey, let's hang out tomorrow. Just really, all of a sudden.
Yeah, this is a long process. Alright. Items waiting for your attention. Alright.
Okay, so if it's items, that means someone probably, like, hiring. Yep. You got Court Bauer and Kevin Kelly.
So,
you're a Kevin Kelly fan?
Yes, I like him a lot. So, accepted. Awesome. Yes, awesome. All right. So now what?
Did you accept his hiring? Your decisions continue. And then you can change up any of these signing stuff right here, such as if you want him as a face, and then what division you want him into.
Yeah, so complete contract?
Yes. Okay. Right. And then sometimes, like if they're a wrestler, you can do medical exams. Okay, you're good with him. You want to check your emails? All these people getting offers. So, if there's anyone you want to, you know, look at, such as, you know, I guess, a big person right here is Brian Pillman. They're trying to steal him. And you already have him, so you might want to check this out.
Ooh.
Yes, so, yeah, WCW and WO is really trying to steal him.
And the, 14,370 a month. I can't do that. As much as I want to keep him. So how do you just go ahead and let him go?
It's not. You can just let him go, but he might be angry. Whereas he just leaves on his own. There's a chance he'll come back later. So, but also, if they take him, you'll have a 7-day notice. So,
what am I doing wrong here? So, I'm supposed to be looking at the rival offer?
Negotiate, yeah. Actually, did they give him one?
Yes, it's.
Oh no, they already made a contract with him, it said. If it's like rival bid, then you can see, I think. Okay. And that's if you want to check it. If not, you can just, you know, delete all your emails and that's it.
Ugh. first one, though. Nine to see, I I could really use him. So what do you crank it up to?
It's kind of like whatever you think would be good for him. The thing though is they're giving him, check the rival offers.
Yeah, it did.
They're giving him a pay written deal to stay there forever. Or not forever, but for the next 4 years, that is. So
written deal. All right. For let's see, rival offers length 4 years. Let's see. Awesome. I kind of want to, help build my company on. So Brian Pillman's been given an offer. Elijah Burke, Jimmy Corderas. I select all. And close. All right, now what?
You probably want to do some signing to, let's see, personal assistant. These two, Kevin Kelly and Court Bauer. So I go to push.
Auto push.
No, go to the push right here. And then wherever you think he deserves, you do recommend push, I guess. He doesn't need a division, by the way. Divisions are if you want to set them up with like a certain, like if they're wrestlers, basically. Like if you want them to only fight in like, cruiserweight divisions, stuff like that.
Walk me through this again.
Yeah, okay, 1 second. Go greet my mom. I just came back from college. I get a recommend push, and then you can set him as announcer. Save it.
Same thing, right?
Okay, so being a road agent, that means that he'll help out when it comes to, making sure the psychology and consistency of the match plays through and everything.
Right. Yeah, he's coming on as a road agent, which I wanted to get as many road agents as I could.
Go to announcers real quick, and then you can change this up of now that you have Kevin Kelly, like if you wanna change up any bit, like for a certain TV deal or
I
something.
would like to put him for now. I would like to put Kevin Kelly for events. Kevin Kelly with Jim Foster and Tim Hurt. No, yeah, I'm not doing that. Or Steven Regal. Announcing is bad. No. He'll just work with me for that. And we'll just have him on the events. That's different than the TV shows, correct?
Events are the pay-per-views, basically.
Okay. Yeah. So now we're waiting to get to the next show. And so I see you have your button on the quick roster.
I do.
Well, I'm just saying that the cursor's there.
Oh.
Anything that needs to be looked at before we go on to the next day?
Nothing at all.
Right, so go ahead and tell me how do we get to simulate so that I can do it without you telling me.
What do you mean?
Without you doing it for me.
Oh, hit the arrow right here.
So how many days do I want to do until one day until Thursday, week one? And how many days? 4 days?
Think it was, what, 3 days?
Okay.
Yeah, 3.
Alright, so Jamie's in town.
That's if nothing happens, by the way.
Right. So we got Kevin Kelly. And we got Court Bauer. And did we get anybody? We're basically waiting on negotiations right now and whether people want to come work for our company or not.
Yeah, but WCW NWO is looking like they're picking up a lot of people at the moment.
Yeah, well, it's all right. I don't have a problem with that because my whole thing was is that I wanted to get WCW NWO and work from there and work with that roster, but I thought how cool would it be to go ahead and book WCW before it blew up and became WCW NWO and try to book it like that. I mean, I wanted to book Mid-South, but eventually I'll book Mid-South. I just think WCW is a good starting point for me. I think it's better than starting my own company right now. Velvet Sky, that's who that is. I was looking at her and going, she looks like Velvet Sky.
Who?
The random profile, that's Velvet Sky.
Velvet Sky? Oh, yeah. I was like, yeah, that's Velvet Sky.
Took me a while.
Really? I know she looks a little bit different, though.
Oh yeah, she's way younger than that.
I think a lot of people are. Like, Gorgeous George, 36 years old.
I know, right? Black and white profile picture. Like he was still alive. Bobo Gazzella's on the roster. I was like, oh my gosh.
They even got, trying to think of the oldest personality they would have. Terry Gordon was injured.
Oh wow.
Dengue fever.
So let's see what's going on here.
You got new people to hire, it looks like. Click on decisions.
Decisions, decisions, decisions. Where would decisions are over here.
The gland.
Yay!
Yep.
I got
Brian.
Baby Hebner.
Is that the son of Earl?
Yes, it is.
They did a segment with him in TNA recently, didn't they? It wasn't really recently, but I remember it.
I have signed Baby Hebner. Okay, I'm still waiting for Sid Vicious, Terry Funk, Young Gazuna, Al Snow, Dean Malenko, Bubba Ray and Devon, Taz, Bob Holly, Bob Sweetan, Brian Clark, Chavo Guerrero Jr., Chris Candido, Christopher Daniels, C.W. Anderson, D'Lo Brown, Earl Hebner, Elijah Burke, Gordon Sully, Matt Stryker, Charles Robinson, Jimmy Corderas, Nick Patrick, Chavo Guerrero Sr., and Dutch Mantel. So, on to the next step. Will we just simulate again?
Check your email real quick. See if there's anything interesting. You never know. So, it looks like... So no one dropped out of the deals yet, but a lot of people are trying to get each other. Chavo Guerrero Sr. I would imagine Triple A being more serious to him.
Yeah. I'm not gonna negotiate too much. Some of the bigger stars that I keep that I'm keeping my eyes on, like there's certain people that I really want, and there's certain people that if I don't get sign them, then you know I move on and I build my roster around the people that are going to be there.
Yeah.
So. Select all. And delete.
Yeah, you're pretty much good to go on the next day.
So, simulate, and that is right here.
The arrow.
The arrow?
Yeah. Enter advance.
So,
and then there's only 2 days left. But I see that someone might be hired probably tomorrow.
Conan was a top-drawing wrestler in Mexico during the mid-90s, and at one stage was called the Mexican Hulk Hogan, was a figurehead of AAA for years before WCW, where his charisma saw him become a top mid-carder. There he had a less impressive run as in TNA, highlighted by his role as a leader of LAX. He was also NWO for life.
I like to think his best... His best part is going to be Lucha. His best part of his career.
Yeah. I wasn't really hot on that at first. But now that I am in the bull rope match between Tejano and Alberto El Patron, and the main event coming up is Cage versus Prince Puma for the world title, that's how far behind I am. Now that I see what Conan's doing and the storyline as far as that goes, I'm like, okay, I can get behind this. It's starting to become very convincing. So yeah, I like the jump around a lot. I'm months behind on it. But you know, that's the way the cookie crumbles. So hopefully we'll be able to go ahead and get to Saturday, but I have a feeling Friday's going to see a bunch of hirings. What say you, good sir?
Yeah, pretty much. You know what I'm thinking? Taco. You know what I'm thinking of for your roster with ICW?
What's that?
You are technically in an alliance with all of WCW. So anything that Ted Turner's really ever owned, you have a say in. I'm gonna kill the spider on my wall, one second.
There are items waiting for my attention. Yay! Gordon Sully, Charles Robinson, and TW Anderson. And CW Anderson is now Gordon Sully, and Charles Robinson. And of course, we're still waiting on some of our big memes. Robinson, referee, push not yet assigned, referee, Brian Hebner. And CW Anderson will be able to start in 1 week. Push, change, shoe.
Okay, I'm back, you there.
So, should CW Anderson be old school?
Oh, you don't need a division for him, don't worry. Yeah, the divisions are when you have, like, a really big roster, and that's when you need to separate them by, like, you know, if you want, okay, think of, like, X division, you know, you have, like, the High Flyer division. That's what I would mean, like.
So, message from personal assistant says CW Anderson will be available to start with in a week, so there's nothing I can do about it, so.
He's probably, let me see him real quick. He is currently... Yeah, so he's working with ECW at the moment, so you have to give him 7 days to, you know, fill out any loose ends. So.
Brian Hebner signs at ECWA.
I got a problem. I killed a spider that was, like, crawling on my wall, but now it's stuck behind my Dr. Doom poster. Like, I smashed it while he was behind there, and, like, half of his guts are on the side of the poster, and the other half are inside of it, dead, so. Who's that? Brian Pillman? Or Christopher Daniels?
And, I'm gonna withdraw my offer.
Problem.
I am not gonna go after him anymore. Wait.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Not a problem. Chavo Guerrero doesn't work for us, and that's okay. I've got Baby Hebner.
Is he written?
Well, he's already been signed to the roster. He's paid for appearance. Alright, now, anything else? or do we go now to the next day?
We should be good, and the show is tomorrow night.
Yes, sir. AJ Styles, wow. How far that guy's come.
Oh, yeah. And without the WWE.
Exactly. I mean, well, he was in WWE in, like as, I don't want to call him a jobber because he was, like, on, like, he was on Heat or Jacked or something like that.
Velocity.
Yeah. No, actually, he was on Heat or Jacked before he was on Velocity.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think, what was Velocity? Was that Saturday nights?
I think it was. It was the SmackDown with green lighting instead of blue.
Yeah, I never watched Jack though. I watched
Jacked was
Heat.
Back, it was when it was still WWF. Jacked was like a Saturday thing.
I don't think he would have been there. Because didn't he do something in WCW though? Near the end?
I don't remember.
Because he was Air Styles.
Well, I would remember that because I was well aware of the Cruiserweights because I was watching WCW at the time. And I remember reading the magazine, waiting for the AOL Time Warner deal to go through, and I was hoping that it was going to, and it didn't, and I thought, you know, that Eric Bischoff and Vince Russo were just gonna, you know, start everything over again, and I thought that, you know, they were gonna, you know, strip everybody of the world titles again. Everybody's gonna get stripped of their titles again, so I was waiting on that, so I don't remember AJ Styles. Maybe he was on like a, you know, WCW Saturday Night episode that I don't remember.
I'm looking this up right now to see what he's a part of also. Let's see. His early career. Crazy part is this guy's only 38 years old.
Yeah. Yes, I would like to jump straight in my office. Decisions. Contract negotiation.
It's a lot of people now you got.
Wait a minute.
Look at all those people you're gonna hire now.
Wait, these are all people that said yes?
Yeah.
No crap.
Yeah.
Alright.
So you got some work to do.
Medical exam, yes. Okay, cool. Complete contract. Alright. Everybody gets a medical exam.
So in 1998, he was in the NWA Wild Side. And that went on to WCW in 2001, when he became Air Styles.
I have a lot of NWA Wildside on VHS.
He teamed up with
I got
Paris.
I got Bubba Ray, but I didn't get Devon.
Okay, you were right with one part. He did go on later to wrestle on Jacked in 2002.
Yep.
He was at WCW until the end. Let's see. He went to tour in Australia for a year, and then he went back to the NWA Wildside.
Dude, he was such a pimple faced little thing when I first saw him.
What?
The labs are reporting that their tests are showing that Chris Candido has signs of being a heavy user of hard drugs. Do I withdraw my contract?
You gotta think though, how many people on your roster do you think are doing drugs also? Like, is there anyone on the roster you think is also doing drugs?
The only person that has come up so far has been Chris Candido.
Well, that's the only person you've done a medical exam for, though, haven't you?
No, everybody's gotten a medical exam so far.
How about your active roster? Look at medical backstage, drug test, and then. Do you want to try this?
Go ahead.
Okay. Would you like to do the standard or comprehensive test?
Standard would be that they're not using, like, marijuana or cocaine. Comprehensive.
They're using heavy stuff.
Yeah. Comprehensive.
Comprehensive is everything.
I would probably not have a roster.
So standard. So you ready?
Yep.
Ding, 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 ding. And our winners tonight are Brian Pillman, Lex Luger, Max Payne, Paul Orndorff, Rick Rude, and Ron Simmons.
Wow.
You can actually click on every single one of these, like Brian Pillman, and it'll say exactly what they've done. So Brian Pillman is a hard drug user.
Wow.
So you can take whatever approach you want to, how you want your company to be viewed.
You'll try not to get.
I will get caught by you later, I'm sorry. Lex Luger is a steroid user.
Good. Bye.
Why? What happened? What'd you do?
I read him the Riot Act.
Oh. Soft drug user?
Sounds like Paul Orndorff. I find him. Ron Simmons. Steroid user. Ah. Dude. Ah. Ah. So, let's see here.
So, Chris Candido, what was he? Heavy or?
Oh, let's see. The medical exam came back that he was a heavy drug user. Is all it was.
Oh, it's whatever you want to do with him. This is before he signed, so.
Let's hope this dude doesn't have a fucking drug problem. Clean, yay!
Oh, come on, it's D'Lo Brown.
You're looking at the real deal now. Earl Hebner. I got Earl Hebner, yay!
But what if Earl Hebner's, like, using heavy drugs?
Clean.
He's pulling, like, every drug there is.
Okay. Elijah Brown from right here in Jacksonville. Yeah, that's bullshit. I know he smokes weed. Jimmy Corderas, clean. Yes. Nick Patrick, probably a weed smoker.
Clean. He
came back clean. Chavo Guerrero Senior. Weed smoker.
Clean. Watch the very last person.
That's right. Mantel.
Weed.
Dirty,
weed.
Dirty. Dirty. Dirty.
Weed. The people.
Oh. Wow. Weed. The people.
Well. Looks like you gotta sign all those people. Well, you can always auto push, by the way, to make your life
auto
easier.
push?
Yeah. So it's right next to view profile.
Right next to view profile. Okay. I'm a little stupid here.
It's you hit auto push right here. And then auto push. And then yes. And then you should be good for everyone that is going to be able to, you know, show up. And then these are people who are either angry or won't show up.
So, now on to the show.
Uh-huh.
So, how do we go to the show?
You just hit the advance.
This right here?
Yup. Advance, and then boom. It's going to take you to the PM.
This has been interesting. Drug testing people and reading people the riot acts.
Well, something went down.
Alright. Let's see here. He's extremely wonderful. So, how do I go ahead and book this or run it? Hello.
Hey, locker room incident, real quick. You okay?
Oh, that's so funny.
You seem surprised.
I just, that's so fucking funny.
The only one with a problem, too.
Yeah. So
now you're gonna hit this little icon right here.
Alright.
Okay, and then you can just add from pre-booking.
Add from pre-booking?
Yep. You can just add to the booking grid. And we'll just drop it right in there.
Ooh. Road agent is, who's my road agent? Court Bauer. Referee is Vinny J. Announcers are Chris Cruz, Jesse Ventura, Jim Foster, and save. Okay. Thank you. And now what?
Did you add everything from the pre-booking?
No, I didn't, because the attack doesn't make any sense now. Big Van Vader attacks Van Hammer for no reason. I had a storyline to go with, but I'm just going to delete that. Now, do I delete this, or does it take, if I go delete booking, does it take everything away? Are you laughing at me?
No, I was laughing at the second I saw on Facebook. Because they just announced something at E3 that was $60, and this guy put it on eBay for $1,000. And then right under it was a picture of Patrick Starr from SpongeBob, and it said, "I'll take 20." So, yeah, you can add anything from the pre-booking you want. You can change it up. You gotta think, though, of how much TV time you have. Like, you only got 10 more minutes left on this Saturday night of wrestling. So, it looks like you might need one. Wait, let me see. Go right here to your cell phone. Product.
Turner Wrestling.
So, you need at least one segment, it looks like. And you'll be good. So, you might want to bring that segment in there. That's it.
Like a fatal four-way for the world title. And I don't see it anywhere.
Do you have enough time for a match?
Yeah, I got 10 minutes. Let's go ahead. Let's get ourselves a world champion. 10 minutes. Oops. We're running out of time!
3 minutes!
Did I just hear myself say 3 minutes?
Rips off the mask.
Let's see. Ron Simmons. Versus. Let's give Luger a title shot and see what happens here. Save. And there we go. All done.
So you hit run show?
Run show. Boom. In a match that had some good action and average heat, Paul Orndorff defeated Lord Steven Regal. Wow. In a bout that had solid in-ring action but not much in the way of heat, Pratt outshot Brian Pillman, defeated Bunkhouse Buck and Mr. Hughes in 14-5, and Brian Pillman defeated Mr. Hughes by pinball with a missile drop kick. Ricky Steamboat, in a bout that had good crowd and good action, Ricky Steamboat defeated Ron Simmons. And Lex Luger wins the World Heavyweight title. Boo.
I can't believe you put the title on him.
I didn't say, hey, let's put the title on Mike. I was like, what the hell, let's...
So, it said the crowd wasn't happy because there's a missing angles. Okay. You got plus 11 and minus 5. So, it was pretty good. The regions that you aren't getting seen in, probably, you know, such as, like, Japan and some of that, is where you're going to lose respect, but... It's all good. That should be day one.
So we're going to go ahead and end this booking segment, and I will, and we will do the rest of the booking off screen. And for that is my first TEW booking, and it, it's going to take some getting used to, but I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you to Vtech for helping me set everything up and helping me get my first show booked and my roster filled and actually getting actual wrestlers on my roster. It's TEW number one. Thanks.